Very good morning, students, and welcome back. Today, we are going to read a travel blog titled
On an African Safari.
Here, the first question that comes to our mind is,
what is a travel blog? A blog is a type of website that is updated regularly in the form of posts. These posts can be stories and or snippets of information, reviews, photographs, images, podcasts, etc. A travel blog is simply a blog where the entire focus is on the world of travel. Today's travel blog is posted by Priyanka on her visit to the Masai Mara National Reserve in Africa.
Now let us see what do we find in this African safari.
On an African safari. When my parents announced that we were booked on an African safari in the first week of July, I jumped with excitement and joy. Our destination was the Masai Mara National Reserve, which is one of Africa's greatest wildlife reserves, situated in southwest Kenya. It is famous for the Big Five: lions, elephants, rhinos, leopards, and wild buffaloes. I couldn't believe I was actually going to see these beautiful beasts in their natural home. Dad told me to pack a rucksack with a pair of binoculars, my camera, a water bottle, a pen knife, and a notebook, which would come in useful. Priyanka is a girl who loves traveling and writing blogs about her travels. There was no limit to her excitement when she heard that she is going on an African safari with her parents. Masai Mara National Reserve, located in Narok, Kenya, Africa. Masai Mara National Reserve is extended in an area of 1,510 square kilometers, named in the honor of the Masai people. Renowned for its exceptional population of lions, African leopard, cheetah, African bush elephant. Black rhino is also found here, which numbers between 35 to 50. Priyanka is preparing for the safari, which is going to start in the first week of July. Her father tells her to pack some useful things like binoculars, camera, water bottle, pen knife, and a notebook in a rucksack. A few weeks later, our small plane prepared to land at the Mara Serena airstrip. We were treated to the breathtaking view of miles of open savanna, swamps, and forests along the bank of the river Mara. Suddenly, a most attractive sight met our eyes. It was the wild beast migration. Hundreds of gnus running in a mass across the open land and getting into the powerful water as they fought against fast currents and waiting crocodiles. Dad said we were indeed lucky to witness the sight, and I couldn't take my eyes off the scene. Now they have landed at the Mara Serena airstrip. Mara Serena airstrip is surrounded by large open grassland, which is so beautiful that a sight of it is like a welcome gift to the tourists who land here. The view of the Mara River, the wet area around it, and the forest along the river compose such a natural beauty that it takes away the breath of the viewers. Suddenly, they saw hundreds of gnus running across the grassland towards the river to cross the river. But it is not an easy task for them. First, they have to fight the fast-flowing, powerful water of the river Mara. Second, the crocodiles who were waiting for these gnus to feast on them. Every day, hundreds of gnus have to cross the river in search of food. Some unlucky ones are flown away by the river water and some are caught by the hungry crocodiles. Rest pass the river. This is the law of the nature. Priyanka's father said they were very lucky to witness the sight. Priyanka couldn't take her eyes off the scene. Our safari guide was called Ekinlana, meaning brave. He grew up in a Masai village. We became friends almost immediately. He was a source of knowledge on everything from elephant behavior to the secret world of the termite mound. He also had a never-ending store of stories to tell us around the campfire at night. If we are in a place like Masai Mara, we must have a guide because they know directions, animal behavior, and more. They can get us closer to the wildlife for a unique experience. Priyanka and family also hired a local guide from Masai village. His name was Ekinlana. His nature was very friendly. He had great knowledge about the region and uncountable stories to tell about his experiences as a guide. That night, we slept under the stars. I thought I would never get to sleep as I fixed my eyes on the lightning in the distance and trained my ears to the soft sounds of the winds. For a girl like Priyanka, who lives in a city and spends a comfortable lifestyle, sleeping under the open sky was an unforgettable experience for her. She was continuously looking at the stars. She was also looking at the lightning which was taking place in the distance away from her. Generally, people avoid coming out in the fields during lightning, but Priyanka is enjoying the scenario, and the soft cold wind of night are pleasing her ears like a mesmerizing song. In the morning, Ekinlana showed us large paw prints pressed into the white sandy track. "Lion?" I asked, and he nodded. With Ekinlana's help, we traced the tracks for a few kilometers until we turned around a corner, and there he was, a huge male resting in the open. Nearby, a couple of cubs played under the watchful eye of their mother. I was even able to take some pictures of the family. The male lion is the head of the family. It's his job to protect the lioness and the young cubs. Lioness has a lots of work to do. Not only they look after their cubs, but they also have to go out to hunt for food to feed the cub and the lion. Generally, lions live together in a family group called a pride, which usually has about 13 lions. Often, a small family of lions spend days away from the pride, particularly when looking for food or water. And the next morning, Ekinlana showed them large paw prints on the white sand. When followed, it led them to one such family of lions. Lioness and two cubs. The male was resting and lioness was looking after the cub. They were playing. Priyanka managed to take some pictures of the family somehow. Our open jeep crossed the grassland almost silently. A large herd of zebras hardly looked up even when we drove quite close to them. They looked so much like horses, it was tempting to want to ride them. Ekinlana told us that zebras were the favorite food of some animals, and sure enough, we saw our first cheetah sitting on a termite mound looking at the herd for snacks. Open jeeps are considered best for the safari. You can spot the majestic wildlife in their natural habitat. Open jeeps allow us to click some amazing pictures of the animals. Priyanka and family and Akinlana are also enjoying the open jeep safari. They saw a herd of zebras. Akinlana took them very close to the herd. They found that zebra's body quite resembles the body of a horse, and they wanted to take a ride on zebras. Then Akinlana told them about zebras, that it's very difficult to domesticate a zebra. They are very wild and aggressive, but zebras are the favorite food of some wild animals like lions, tigers, cheetah, etc. And just then they saw a cheetah sitting on a termite mound looking for an opportunity to attack the herd. It was lush and green just after the rains, and it was very beautiful. That night we put our tents on a hill overlooking the pond where the hippopotamuses lived. Akinlana told us that hippos are among Africa's most dangerous animals. All night I could hear the quiet jungle sounds and the lion's roar. It seemed very close to the tent, and my heart thumped wildly. In Kenya, July is the driest month of the year, with very low rainfall. It may be good luck of Priyanka or the visitors that it rained that day. The rain washed away all the dust and soil from the trees, leaves, and bushes, and everything started appearing green and beautiful around. It was the end of the day. They set up their tents on a hill for a night, hill from where they could see a pond where the hippopotamuses live. Every year across Africa, hippos kill an estimate 500 people, making them the world's deadliest mammals, nearly twice as deadly as lions. Akinlana tells them about the fact. At night, most of the wild animals become active and go out on hunt. That night, Priyanka was already scared after hearing about hippos, and the fearful sound of the animals made her feel they are close to her. That night, Priyanka was terrified and could hardly sleep. The next morning, Akinlana took us to Maremi, a tribal village. The villagers taught us how to drink the nutritious contents of a fruit the size of a watermelon, and the fine art of grabbing a scorpion by the stinger. From a distance, a group of macaques were observing us. They were quite brave, and one even climbed up my dad's shoulder and stood on his head. Moremi village, it's a home to Batwana tribes. The next morning, Akinlana brings them to this village. The villagers welcomed them with their traditional welcome drink. The villagers taught them how to grab a scorpion by the stinger. They saw a group of merkits coming from a distance. Merkits are small mongoose found in southern Africa. They are about 24 to 35 centimeters in length, but very brave like mongoose. One of the merkits climbed Priyanka's dad's shoulder and stood on his head. We drove through the forests. The air was moist and warm, and it was quiet except for the singing of the crickets. Suddenly, we came face to face with a herd of elephants. They were females with their young ones. Females pushed their babies back with their trunks and charged at our jeep. This time, I was really frightened, but Ekinlana explained that it was not a real charge because the elephants were sticking their ears out to make themselves look bigger. If it were real, the ears would be pinned back against the head. Besides, mother elephants never leave their cubs even to charge at an intruder. The male cricket insects can sing to attract female crickets as mates. After moving ahead from Moremi village, they were passing through the forest. It was silence around. The moist and warm air was blowing, and only sound they could hear was the cricket's song. And suddenly they came face to face with the herd of elephants. The herd had some female elephants and their babies. About elephants, they are usually peaceful animals, but the females may be aggressive, especially when their young ones are around them. Priyanka and family were in the jeep. So, in order to avoid any danger, the female elephants pushed their babies back with their trunks and started jolting the jeep. Priyanka was really frightened this time. Ekinlana was calm. He knew about the elephant's behavior. He explained to Priyanka that elephants were not really attacking them. He could say that because elephants' ears were outward. Elephants were just trying to look bigger to scare them. Ekinlana also said if elephants really want to attack them, then their ears would pin backward. But not very often mother elephants leave their babies, even to attack at someone whom they don't want to see. At last, it was the final day of our safari. I woke up at dawn to the beautiful sight of a flock of graceful ostriches. I looked through my binoculars and saw a herd of rhinos grazing lazily in the morning sun. The babies kept close to their mothers. I watched in silence until Ekinlana called out, asking if I wanted to take a dip in the Mara. We spent an hour splashing in the water, having mud fights and playing tug-of-war with a towel. On the way back to the camp, Ekinlana showed me a muddy patch on a tree. "That's where rhinos scratch themselves," he told me. "When you are at Masai Mara, you will never want to wake up the morning that is the last morning of your trip." It was last day of Priyanka at Masai Mara. She woke up and started looking through the binoculars so that if any site is left unexplored, she can go and explore. She caught the sight of a herd of rhinos grazing in the sun. Rhinos are plant eaters, and their babies feed on milk from their mother. The mother rhino was looking after the babies and trying to keep them near her. Ekinlana was an expert guide. He knew that it's Priyanka's last day of the trip, so he wanted her to enjoy instead of going out into the wild. Ekinlana invited her to swim in the Mara River. It is quite obvious that once you are in a river water, you cannot resist yourself from having fun. And this is what happened exactly. Priyanka, her family, and Akinlana splashed water at each other. They had mud fight. They played tug of wars with the towel, and they all fully enjoyed for about an hour. While returning, Akinlana showed Priyanka a muddy patch on a tree, which are created by rhinos in order to remove mud from their bodies, rubbing against trees, rocks, or termite mounds. I was silent on the drive back to the airstrip. I had fallen in love with Masai Mara. I would miss my friend Akinlana. I would miss the sound of the forest, the awesome sunset, my tent, and the drives through the bush that is home to such amazingly beautiful animals. Now I can proudly boast of having seen the giraffe, the tallest mammal on earth, use his thick, long blue tongue to pick leaves from a tree, and a spotted leopard sitting on a branch waiting for prey. I can tell my friends that I woke up every morning to see the bushback deer grazing just outside my tent, and that I have actually held a market baby in my hand. I have been lucky indeed to have had this wonderful opportunity. The natural beauty of Masai Mara can make anyone fall in love with it. And if you have spent some days here, you will make a relationship with the grasslands, hills, rivers, and wildlife of Mara, which will remain alive in your memories and heart forever. For Priyanka, it was very difficult to say goodbye to this place and return back to the airstrip. At last, she boosted up her mind, thinking she has captured each moment she has spent in this amazingly beautiful place. Now she can tell her friends and the world about it. She can tell she came face to face with some most fierce animals in the world. She can tell she met the tallest mammal on earth, the giraffe, and how they pick leaves from trees using their thick, long blue tongue. She can tell how every morning she saw bushbuck deers grazing outside her tent, and how she held a market baby in her hand. Finally, her mind smiles, thinking she is one among the millions who has spent some golden days at the Masai Mara National Reserve. All right, so that is all we have from the African Safari. I hope you liked the video and enjoyed learning about the African Safari. So we will meet again in another video lecture with some new topic. Till then, thank you very much and God bless you all.